It's okay. Open up.
Come on. Get him inside.
What happened?
Got hit again. Squatters off the highway. We've got to get some men together, go after them.
Don't look at me, it ain't my problem.
They've got Manny.
You sent Manny on a supply run.
I just run the camp, D. I don't tell folks how to live their lives.
Go to hell, Cope!
Found his bike. I'm gonna see if I can track him down.
My men said they'd set up an ambush on the Sanium.
Yeah, I already found it. Deacon out.
Yeah, not bad.
Thank you.
wasn't gonna let him kill you. Besides, who the hell is around here knows how to rebuild a carburetor? Just back up. Nice and slow. Don't make a sound.
Jesus, Deke. You did it.
Oh, Jesus. It's clear.
I've been camping too long. Never saw nothing like that before.
Okay. Let's get the hell out of here.
You don't gotta twist my arm on that one.
Yeah, so what the hell happened? What were you doing out here?
I don't know. I hadn't been on a run in months. It felt like maybe I wasn't... I don't know, doing my share, you know?
A lot of assholes with guns out here, Manny. Not many know how to fix the shit that they ride around on.
Yeah, that's what folks say.
For once, I agree with the son of a bitch.
So what do you think? Why's it gotta be this way?
Be what way?
Everyone out here trying to kill everyone else.
Manny, you know how many folks were locked up in prisons before the shit went down? I mean, here in the States...
No idea.
2.5 million. You count the ones that are out on parole and probation, that's almost 7 million. So, 1 in 35 was someone who didn't give a shit about the law. And those are just the ones that got caught.
Shit.
So the question isn't, why is it like this now? The question is, why wasn't it always like this?
Guess I'll be sticking to the camp from now on.
You good from here?
Yeah. Hey, Deke, I owe you, man. I'd be dead right now if you hadn't...
Manny, nose down.
Nose down. They feed you.
Now get the hell out of here.
Found him.
Thank God and country. He's alive?
He's a little banged up, but he'll live.
I'm guessing a few drifters are trying to find out about your camp. How many men you have, how many guns.
I hope he told them. We have all the damn guns we need, and we mean to keep them. Fitz don't got no more to say about that now, do they?
No, I guess they don't.
When Andy gets back, tell him to keep his nose down. St. John out.
The old sawmill. This ought to be easy, right? I just gotta make sure I have enough traps, ammo, Molotovs, and anything else I can carry.
Brother, you're killing me. Where are you getting the creosote?
You just like driving that dump truck around.
You're goddamn right I do.
Alright, I'm heading to the old sawmill. They got a couple of storage tanks there. They should have all the creosote we need.
The old sawmill? Last I checked, there was a horde there. Big goddamn horde.
Yeah. I'm, pretty sure I knew that.
What, you still got a death wish? I mean, even after finding your old lady, Deke, we're gonna get her back.
Blues man, no, I don't. Look, I can handle this. Just be ready. I'll radio when it's clear to bring your rig in. Deacon out. Okay, what were you saying?
He is head of security. He has to tell me. You remember when I took you to the sawmill, right? You remember me showing you the horde that lives there?
Oh, yeah, I remember.
The really big horde that lives, sleeps, and eats there.
Yeah, like I said.
Holy shit, dude. Looks like I missed all the fun.
Yeah. Next time, I drive the truck. You fight the freakers.
Yeah, brother.
Okay, just pull it over there.
All right, you got it.
All right, that's it. Head back to camp. I'll meet you there.
All right.
And, Boozman, drive carefully.
What do you think? That I'm gonna blow myself up?
Hey, Ricky, what's up?
There's still some work I need to do on the truck. I'll radio you when it's ready.
Thank you. I'm ready when you are.
Deke, you sure you want to do this?
They're coming, Ricky. Unless we take him out first.
You're right. Okay, Ricky out.
Okay.
Deke?
Yeah, Ricky.
Boozer just told me you're heading to the old sawmill.
Yeah, and Boozer has a big mouth.
He is head of security. He has to tell me. You remember when I took you to the sawmill, right? You remember me showing you the horde that lives there?
Oh, yeah, I remember.
The really big horde that lives, sleeps, and eats there.
Yeah, like I said, I remember. Look, Ricky, when I was with the militia, we created a sort of souped-up Molotov.
A souped-up Molotov?
Yeah, it's like napalm. Anyway, trust me, I got this.
We need you, Deke, alive.
Ricky, just, I'll be fine. You don't gotta worry about me no more, okay? I know what I'm doing. Ricky?
Yeah, Deke.
I'm, just lighting some candles.
Okay.
And in this case, some big goddamn Molotovs, but, you know, you get the idea.
Yeah, okay.
Deacon out.
Deacon St. John, this is Mark Copeland. I just wanted to apologize for that business with your bike. After the things you've been doing to help out the camp, well, I guess I had you figured all wrong. Again, I'm sorry. St. John, this is Copeland. Manny says he's got a part for your bike.
Not sure I have enough camp credits.
So, what were you saying?
When you do, swing by. He'll fix you up. Copeland out.
Whew. Power's off. Figures. Fuel. That should be it.
Cornelius. Damn it. That's gonna bring them all down on me. See if it still works. Ooh. Whoa, that'll do it. Micro-recorders, yeah, wonder what happened here.
Oh my god, what is that smell?
Oh yeah, that's right, you're new here. They fired up the wigwam burner.
The what?
The wigwam burner. See it? Right over there. Looks like a giant rusty salt shaker.
Well, I sure as hell can smell it.
Yeah, back in the 60s, they used to burn sawdust in them. Kept them going 24 hours a day. Kinda look like little volcanoes.
And now they're burning corpses.
I think this is the last load from Farewell. They're shutting it down. We're being moved to a mass gravesite over in Iron Butte.
At least it won't smell as bad.
Yeah, let's hope. Ugh.
It's like Boozer says, they're here a bunk calling.